In Missouri, a brave young boy is also speaking out after a frightening attack. Downtown Cape Girardeau, Missouri, 11:40 p.m. A youth hip-hop group shows off their moves.
We were performing downtown, which is a few blocks over from our studio. It was a very usual thing for us to do on the weekends, just to bring in some extra money for the kiddos.
12-year-old Ethan Hagler, known in the group as E-Man, is one of the students participating in the street performance.
It's not abnormal for Ethan to be out with his friends on a non-school night past 10. It was 4th of July weekend. Ethan went off with his dance friends, just go hang out and dance and be in the downtown atmosphere.
There's a lot of people there. They would walk by and like see us dancing, but we would make sure they don't like stay too close to us.
We're DJing, we're having fun, we're talking to people, and with all the positive energy flowing, I decided to turn on my Facebook Live to show everyone. That's what we do.
We just let it record, and we just start dancing, we start DJing.
I'd seen several cars that were just circling around the block, which was normal.
But within 10 minutes, their night takes a sudden and terrifying turn.
This kid is dancing, and he's having a good time. And this car abruptly stops, and this man gets out of the car.
And he starts to dance along with us. He gets close, and I see him rear back and...
With no warning, the man attacks Ethan.
He just sucker punches this kid out of nowhere.
Ethan's attacker never says a word. He just punches the 12-year-old brutally in the face, then bolts.
I ran after the guy. I tried to catch him, and I saw two other people in the car.
This instructor is in a really precarious situation. He's there to protect these minors.
I'm thinking, do they have guns? I have kids with me. Should I pursue this guy?
Everyone is in shock and in terror.
I remember getting hit. I fell over, and then I blacked out. And then I woke up, and I was crowded with people around me. I was very confused. I was very shocked. And I was like, what just happened? And I didn't know what to do. Blood was going all over the place. Michael immediately called my mom. She ran straight for me. She kept on saying that she was sorry because she wasn't there.
The bouncers at the bar across the street, I kind of waved at them, come here, come here, come here, and they're right on it. They brought out ice, they brought out water to help wash off the blood and made sure that E-Man was okay. They also called 911 for us.
That's when Ethan sees the video of what just happened.
Michael, he gave me the phone and told me what happened. When I saw me fall, I was like, dang. The cop asked me some questions, and the mom took me straight to the closest hospital.
They immediately went and did an MRI.
The doctors told me that I had a seriously bad concussion.
In the ER, Ethan's mom sees the video for the first time.
I was instantly so angry that I felt hot. We watched it over and over and over. And he said, I just want to understand why this happened.
Why did I get it?
By Sunday, 2 days after the attack, hundreds of Facebook users have shared Michael Curry's video. It's viewed more than 970,000 times.
The grown man is attacking a boy from behind.